Hi, and welcome to Vincent Codes Finance. In this video, I'll show you how you can use Python and Playwright to scrape this web page and turn it into a pandas data frame, even if this web page source code doesn't include the actual table. So what's Playwright? Well, Playwright isn't meant for web scraping. It's actually a web testing framework by Microsoft. So the main use case is for web developers who want to test their product. The reason it's useful for scraping is that it provides a headless browser, so Chromium, Firefox, or WebKit, so you can have an actual full-featured browser that is headless, doesn't have a window tied to it, but that is controlled by code. So why is that useful for scraping? Well, it's because most modern web pages nowadays don't even include the data that you want to scrape into the page source. They actually use JavaScript to get that data from different APIs or different servers. So you need to have an engine that can execute that JavaScript and render the page so that you have the data available to scrape. On top of that, Playwright also supports other features such as authentication. So you can scrape websites that require authentication and action. So you can actually fill out forms, click on buttons, stuff like that. As a matter of disclaimer, before you start scraping your website, make sure that you look at the site's policy to make sure that they allow scraping before you proceed. Playwright isn't the only framework for that purpose. So in the past, I've used Selenium, which now kind of feels a bit outdated. Playwright is way more modern. And there's also Puppeteer, which is quite popular, but unfortunately it doesn't have official Python binding. So for that, I prefer to use Playwright. So in this video, what we'll do is we'll start by trying to scrape our page using the request package, which is much simpler. But then we'll see how we might run into issues with that because of the JavaScript nature of that particular web page. Then we'll set up Playwright. We'll scrape the page with Playwright. We'll extract the data and load it into a pandas data frame. And then I'll show you additional Playwright features. Okay, so here's the page that we want to scrape. So this page is from the NASDAQ websites, and it contains quotes from stocks from the NASDAQ 100 index. Now, if I look at the page source, well, it's a bit of a mess, like most modern websites, right? There's not much that we can gather from the page source. Just to be sure, let me search for, say, Airbnb. In this web page, well, it's not there, right? So the data that I'm actually looking for isn't in the actual page source. Okay, so let's go into VS Code. By the way, all the code for this video is available on GitHub. You can look at the video description for the link. It's actually configured to run in the dev container. If you don't want to have to install anything and just run it as a container, it will set up everything you need directly. Typically, when I would scrape a basic website, I would just use the request package that will let me just download the content from a specific URL. So let's try this. So we'll import request. By the way, you need to have it installed. So pip install request. And now I'll copy the URL for the web page that we want to scrape. So in order to scrape that URL, all I have to do is use request.get and pass the URL, and that would give me a response. Okay, so I had to cancel it because of timeout. What's happening here? Well, a lot of websites, if you don't provide a user agent, so telling the website which user is actually accessing or which platform is accessing the website, they just won't reply. That's to block bots and other things like that. So in this case, we'll have to specify a user agent. So what we'll do is we'll pretend that we are a Firefox on Intel Mac. So now we can go back and use our get function. And what we'll do is we'll use get, pass the URL, and then we'll have another parameters, which is headers, which takes a dictionary, and then we'll pass as the user agent what we've defined up here. And now we do get a response. If we look at the content of that response, it is the full HTML. It's actually the source that we saw in the browser before. So for good measure, let's just save this as a file. And now what we'll do is we'll actually have a look at that file. And if we again search for, say, Airbnb, it's not there. So there's no Airbnb in that file. So we're stuck in the same problem, right? The data's not there. This is where Playwright comes in. So in order to install Playwright, you can look at the get started. You can either use pip and then do pip install pytest Playwright, or as I did using poetry, it's just poetry add pytest Playwright. But after that, you also have to install additional dependencies, mainly the headless browsers that you'll be using. So you can run the command Playwright install. In order to use Playwright, we'll have to import the API. So today we'll use the synchronous API. So from playwright.sync API, we'll import sync Playwright. But Playwright also supports an async API if you want to make multiple requests within the same trait. So I don't want to get into that for today's video, but it is a feature that is available within Playwright. So in order to scrape using Playwright, we'll have to set up a few things. So we'll use a with sync Playwright context. So everything will work into that context. And then what we'll do is we'll first create our browser. So we'll create a Firefox browser, which will launch to activate it. Then within that browser, we'll have to create a context. And to that context, we'll actually pass the user agent. So it's going to use our user agent that we've defined earlier. I don't think there is a one-to-one relationship with that, but the way I see the context, it's a bit like a profile, right? So you have to create a context, and then within that context, we'll create a new page, right? And everything can be done within a page. By the way, in this case, we'll only load one page and scrape one page, but if you were scraping multiple pages, you can actually just create the browser in the context once, create your page, and then move from one URL to another within that page. You don't have to reinitialize everything. And then what we'll do is we'll just go to that URL using page go to, then pass the URL and an optional timeout. So this website seem to be a bit slow in this case, so I increased the timeout compared to the default one because sometimes I did have some timeouts. So here I'm having a timeout of 5 seconds. And once that's done, what I'll do is I'll save the content into a new variable. So I'll do page.content. And content, by the way, is a function, so I'll have to put the parenthesis, and that's going to save the content there. So I'll run this. What's this issue I'm getting? Well, I'm getting that in Jupyter in the interactive window, we're actually running into an async loop, so I can't use the async API there, which is fine. I'll just create a Python script, which is, in any case, my preferred method for running scraping scripts like this. So that way they are replicable, easier to store. So we'll switch and repeat everything within a Python script. Okay, so now we've got the same code in a script. I'll just make sure that I print the content at the end so that we see it. We save and play. And now it is running in the terminal here. And what we do have is, yeah, we're getting something. Okay, is it better? Is it not than what we had before? Well, for that, we'll have to actually look at the data. So instead of just printing the data, what I'll do is I'll save it to a file. So we'll get the content from there. Let me save and run. Now, if we look at our Playwright file, let me search again for Airbnb. Now I seem to find it. So it's the data has been loaded into the page before I save the HTML. So now if I want to convert that as a data frame, well, I'll just use pandas. Pandas is pretty great as taking HTML tables and turning them into data frames. So I'll go back into my interactive window here. I'll import pandas. And once I've got that, I will use the read HTML function, which requires the LXML package as a dependency. So pip install LXML or poetry add LXML for that. And now all I have to do is create a data frame where I do pandas read HTML. And now I'm using my Playwright HTML file. If I'm reading this, actually, it won't be a data frame directly because what we're getting is a list of data frame. So pandas, this read HTML method, actually what it does is it returns a list of data frames for one data frame for each table in the web page. In this case, there's only one. So we can just, before assigning it to our data frame, we can just pick the first one here. And now we have a full-featured data frame which contains all the data from that web page. So we've achieved our goal. Now let's look at other features from Playwright. But just before we do, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe button so that you get notified of my future videos. So another feature that's pretty cool is the screenshot feature. So for that, all I have to do is go at page and then screenshot. And then I can use the screenshot.png. So just provide the path where to store that screenshot. And then I'll use the full page option to make sure that it takes a screenshot of the full complete web page. So from top to bottom, just not only the view that you typically see on the browser, but the full page. And if I do that and I run this, when I get the screenshot, it's actually, it looks like this. So I get a screenshot of the full page. So that's quite useful if what you want to get out of the website is not only the text, but the actual image or kind of the view of that web page. Another thing that I found quite useful while scraping, not this website, but other websites, is that sometimes you need the page to load completely before you want to scrape. Playwright is pretty good at automatically waiting for everything to load, but sometimes that's not even enough. So for that, you can use the page.waitForTimeout method to wait for the time that you want. It is the preferred method, so Playwright recommends not using time.sleep in order to pause, but really using this method. And for me, that's helped me quite a lot with different websites. And if we go back to the Playwright documentation, there are other features that you might want to explore on your own. So there's the action part of the API, which lets you either click button, fill out forms, things like that. So here you have all the instructions on how to do that. There is the authentication section, which covers how to authenticate into websites that you want to go and access. There's the browser section here that lets you see the different options for the different browsers. So there's the download section that lets you handle, say, automatic downloads and things like that. So files that you want to download that might be triggered automatically or that you'd have to click to download. But this section discusses all of that. And if you want more details on the screenshots, you can come here and look at kind of different options for that. You can even make videos of your browsing on different websites if you want. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please like and make sure to subscribe so that you get notified of my future videos.